Is it okay to leave a thumb drive plugged in all the time? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. If you're not getting my weekly newsletter, askleo.com/newsletter and sign up for Confident Computing. Weekly tips, tricks, answers, and more to help you use technology with greater confidence. This was a lengthy question, but I'm going to jump to the three questions that ultimately got asked. Is it harmful to the flash drive to just leave it plugged in 24/7? Why is it necessary to shut the flash drive down before removing it? And what wears out? Why do things wear out on a flash drive? They're supposedly solid state. So I'm going to address these questions in reverse order. Yes, a flash drive is indeed solid state. There are no moving parts, other than electrons, of course. The issue is that flash memory, by its nature, by its design, wears just a little bit each time something is written to it. It has to do with the physical properties of the solid state circuitry, the actual hardware, if you will, that's being used in those circuits. They wear every time you write to it. Write to it enough, and yeah, eventually it's going to fail. The question, of course, is, great, how do I know what's going to happen? Can you predict? No, not really. The problem is that, of course, exactly how long flash memory will last depends on a number of different things, but ultimately, the quality of the electronics being used and the number of times you write to it. For example, a thumb drive, a flash thumb drive, is probably going to be cheaper materials, cheaper electronics, than, say, an SSD, a solid-state drive that's installed in your computer. The solid-state drive is designed to last much, much longer and therefore has a much higher number of writes that can happen to it before it actually starts to fail, and it comes at a commensurately higher price. I have at least one machine in my basement that's been running an SSD pretty much constantly, 24/7, for the last 10 years, and it shows no sign of wearing out. Of course, that leads us to the other thing of the number of writes. Am I writing to it excessively? Well, apparently not. But that ultimately is the big determining factor as well when it comes to understanding why an SSD or flash memory will wear out. Why safely remove? Safely remove hardware exists not just for flash memory, but for actually any removable disk type device. The concept here is fairly simple. In order for Windows to speed things up, to be as fast as it possibly can, it may not actually finish writing everything to that device after it says it's done. By that I mean an application will say, write this file to the flash drive, and Windows will say, okay, I'm done, when it's not. It's still buffering. It's still writing things out to that flash drive. If you pull the drive while that writing is happening, even though everything says it's done, then you could potentially corrupt the data that's on that flash drive because it's been incompletely written. Now, the good news here is that Microsoft made a change to Windows not that long ago that actually changes how that buffering happens. It happens less aggressively. I'll just call it less aggressively. So that 9 times out of 10, yeah, you're perfectly safe to just yank the USB flash drive. Actual external hard drives, because they're a little bit slower, wouldn't necessarily do this with, but flash drives, because they typically are somewhat faster, it's probably okay. Nonetheless, I still recommend, and when I remember, I still use safely remove hardware, because all that does is it makes sure that Windows is completely done writing whatever it needs to write to that device before letting you know that it's safe to remove. Should you leave it plugged in? Well, this comes back to my most common answer of all time. It depends. What it depends on is actually pretty easy. Is the device being written to, even occasionally, while it's being left plugged in? If the answer is no, then it really doesn't matter. You can leave it plugged in all you want. Even if it is getting written to a little bit, it's probably okay. The real question is it being written to a lot? And that could be any number of different things, sometimes things that we really don't realize, anti-malware software, indexing software, other utilities, Windows itself. It's rare, it's unlikely, it's not something that I think about a lot, but it is possible that your device could be getting written to even when you're not actively using it. And yes, that writing to it will, to some percentage, reduce its usable lifespan. My thinking, my guess, my belief is that it's a tiny percentage, right? It's not something that I would really sweat. But to answer the question accurately, yeah, if it's being written to, then you're shortening the life. Now, the good news here, by the way, is that if you are actually shutting down the machine, if the machine is turned off, it's not being written to. If the machine is in hibernate, it's not being written to. If the machine is in standby, it's also probably not being written to, but I have heard of enough machines waking up from standby on their own that I would at least understand whether or not your machine is coming back from standby without your actually having done anything before making the assumption. It's a hard risk to quantify, even though it really boils down to two and only two things. How good is the hardware? And for most flash drives, you and I won't know. And how much is it being written to? Again, for a flash drive, it depends on what's happening on your system. Chances are it's not being written to very much, but if it is, then yeah, I probably wouldn't do it. The way I characterize it is simply this. It's Murphy's Law. The failure will happen when it's most inconvenient and least expected. If you take away nothing else from this discussion, let it be this. Your flash drive can fail. It could fail today. It could fail 10 years from now. We don't know whether it's plugged in or not. But that's true of any media, of any disk. Your hard disks could fail, your SSDs could fail, your flash drives could fail, what you write to your CDs and DVDs could all fail. You gotta back up. If it's in one and only one place, you're not backed up and your information is at risk of loss if that one place fails. And they can all fail. So take that away. Don't necessarily worry as much about whether or not it's okay to leave the flash drive plugged in. Just make sure that whatever's on it is somewhere else too. For comments, for updates, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/4224. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.